Congressman James Lankford, and I'd hope to be with you this evening to honor the people who received the ministry of City Rescue, and to personally thank Tom and the staff and the supporters of this great organization. But obviously there are a few things happening right now in our nation's capital that require my attendance. I humbly ask for your continued prayer for our nation in that. For more than 50 years, City Rescue Mission has met people at their point of need and dedicated themselves to serve each person physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually. No one hopes one day to live at City Rescue, but people do come there and find hope. This is a place where people can start over. We see each person is created in the image of God and full of tremendous potential, but each person is also affected by their decisions, circumstances, and family situation. When things go terribly wrong, is there any place where the downward spiral can end? Thankfully, yes. Many people in Oklahoma see the human needs and have great compassion for each person, but they wonder how they can help and who they can turn to with questions on homelessness. Well, here's an idea. How about City Rescue Mission? You can feed now, speak now, and act now. Let me walk you through that. You can feed now. You can donate or bring items for the food drive this Thanksgiving or Christmas. The holidays are tough times, but you know people are hungry and needy in times other than just Thanksgiving or Christmas. But you can donate, get involved, and feed now. That actually lasts through the holidays and year-round. You can also speak now. You can speak out about the issues, point out the needs. Oklahoma City's own author, Ralph Ellison, spoke about this in 1952. He spoke out in his book, The Invisible Man, about the injustice of ignoring the racial realities that are right in front of you, but you don't want to see it. Sometimes, homeless and hungry people are something that we don't want to see. We ignore it just because we don't want to admit there's a problem. But we cannot, and we should not. We must also act now, though. Volunteer. Partner with City Rescue. Direct people to the website. Find ways to support their mission of 800,000 meals before the end of this year. But in many ways, I know I'm preaching to the choir. You already do all these things, or you wouldn't be here. You already believe these things. Thank you for living out our obligations to serve those in need and speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves. This is not about a program or even about an organization. It's about neighbors helping neighbors when they need help the most. At a shelter I volunteered with when I was in college, the director had many great words of wisdom for the people we served and for the volunteer staff. I can still hear his voice ringing in my head. When I was in the kitchen, he would always yell out, "If you have time to lean, you have time to clean." And then he would grab me and other volunteers out of the kitchen. And he would remind us that the people we served didn't just need a meal. They needed the love of Christ. And they needed a person of compassion to talk to. And he'd sit us right down at a table with someone to go life on life. See, I believe as he did, that poverty will not be solved by giving someone a dollar. Poverty will not be solved by a program. You can't solve poverty at arm's length. Poverty is only solved up close, one life, and one family at a time. Thank you for loving people up close. You are the people who understand the words of Jesus when he said in Matthew 25 that the King of Glory would one day say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will say to him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink?" And the king will reply, "Truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters, you did for me." Thank you for watching out for the least of these. God bless you in the ministry we do together at City Rescue. Now let's get to work.